When I come to the end of my journey and I travel my last weary mile, just forget if you can that I ever frowned and remember only my smile. Forget unkind words I have spoken. Remember some good I have done. Forget that I ever had heartache. And remember, I've had loads of fun. Forget that I've stumbled and blundered and sometimes fell by the way. Remember, I've fought some hard battles and won at the close of the day. Then forget to grieve for my going. I would not have you sad for a day. But in summer, just gather some flowers and remember the place where I lay. And come in the shade of the evening when the sun paints the sky in the west. Stand for a few moments beside me and remember only my best. Raquan, Kemar, Tairese, Gaskin of Pile Bay, Spring Garden, St. Michael, and Toronto, Canada. Employee of the Bearded Rose Restaurant, quietly departed this life on Tuesday, January 9th, 2024, at the age of 23. Raquan, Kemar, Tairese Gaskin, affectionately known as Rat Rat or Flexer. Son of Janelle Gaskin and the late Ryan Briggs. Adoptive son of Junior Farrell. Father of Rakairo and Relayla Gaskin. Grandson of Janice Gaskin, Leonard Moore, and Richard Hunt. Stepson of Shad Griffith. Brother of Runaquo McIntosh, Romani Gaskin, and Ija Pinder. Nephew of Jamar, Kemar, Danielle, Wanda, Shakira, Janelle, Quinzel, and many others. Great nephew of Jack, Gregory, Peter Gaskin, Annette, Adriana, and Hamida. Cousin of Peter, Kedra, Tamisha, Akil, Kamisha, Covell, Dwayne, Rashawn, Shay, Stacy, Kemar, Selena, and many others. Godson of Kenny, Matthew, Rhonda, Stacy, Joyanne, Kimberly, and Lucian. Friend of Shakita, Kalicia, Tatiana, Hassani, Thorny, Rashawn, Travier, Amar, Kevin Stout, Baggio, Kalia, Jamal, Donna, Shakim, Kemar, Rajan, Tia, Princess, Anmar, Patterson, and many others. Relative of the Gaskin, Moore, Briggs, Payne, and Tull families. A service of thanksgiving to celebrate the life of Raquan, Kemar, Tairese Gaskin takes place at the New Dimension Ministries, Barbies Hill, St. Michael, on Saturday, February 10th, 2024, at 2 p.m. The interment will follow in the Westbury Cemetery, Westbury Road, St. Michael. Funeral arrangements have been entrusted to the care of Prestige Funeral Services, Paradise Road, Black Rock, St. Michael. you may join the family for the live streaming of the service and the interment at sharingmemoriesforever.live/Raquan Gaskin.
Like a comet blazing across the evening sky, gone too soon. Like a rainbow fading in the twinkling of an eye, gone too soon. Shining, sparkling, and splendidly bright, here one day, gone one night. Like the loss of sunlight on a cloudy afternoon, upon a sandy beach, gone too soon. Like a perfect flower that is just beyond your reach, gone too soon. A sunset dying with the rising of the moon.
I see. up like an eagle, and I will soar with you. Your spirit leads me on in the power of your love. Lord, unveil my eyes, let me see your face to face, the knowledge of your love as you live in me. Lord, renew my mind as your will unfolds in my life, and live in every day by the power of your love. Hold me close, let your love
invite Winslow Gaskin to offer a tribute.
Good evening, everyone. All right. Ooh, to Raquan. Yeah. I met you as a baby and thinking that you were so tiny, and how much you look like your mom, and yet still your dad. And returning to home to tell my mom that I had just saw you, and you should see him. He's so cute, and yeah, I saw him first. I can remember having you around in some years to follow, where you would join the other boys in the family on weekends. And you would be running around being a boy until my mom would be asking, "Where Raquan? Bring him inside. I ain't want he on the road." And I would have to turn to remind her, "He's a boy. And when he's ready, he's going to come inside. Let him be. He's going to be good." Our family picnics you would come to, and everyone would enjoy having you there in all smiles, even your dad. I would always take the time to just look at you, Raquan. Kemar and Rashawn running around with all the smiles on their faces. And with the stretch out shirts too. Knowing you were comfortable and happy was enough to make me smile. And all I could do is relish in that moment. I also have a photo of you to prove it as well. Kemar would attend some of your events, rather it be straight out of Gold Cup or a boat cruise. Freak geeks and gangsters, as some of you would know. In the earlier times of you being the boss promoter you turned out to be, spending time with her cousin was it for Kemar, and also Kemar. Kira could remember bringing you up on weekends to be with her, and also having attend some of the cruises as the party auntie, and always talking to you on the phone and in person when you would call and ask where you at, and then show up where our conversations, or rather their conversations, would range from girl problems to business plans, where you would always wanted to make enough money so you could take care of your family and your mom. My love for you was at first sight. I will always love you. When you called and said that your son was born. On your birthday, you were so excited, letting me know when he was settled, you would bring baby over to meet us. Then one day you called and you asked, where you are, auntie, and showed up with baby girl, to my surprise. I am so happy to have met them, both of them. I remember you are always coming to give us a shout and spending time, even if it's just an hour of your time. We appreciate you. We love you. You have always greeted us as auntie. Nothing else but auntie. And I, for sure, felt special whenever you said it. We are so proud of you. We are so proud to have you a part of our lives. Oh my God, this is ridiculous. I'm not done, I ain't finished. No. I am so proud to have you in our lives. And we will definitely miss you from then until now. Kemar, I can't find your piece for you. Give me your phone.
Your phone?
And Kemar has this to say. It's crazy how we made plans for life that is not promised. We shared almost the same goals in life, to be successful and to take care of our families. The love with each other was always over the roof, knowing we both shared the same names and love we both shared. Laughing, chatting of our plans was a motivation. But now, I have to keep motivated and let love, and let them live forever through me. R.I.P. Bloody, miss you like crazy. Long live Raquan Kemar Gaskin. Thank you.
We want to thank his aunt for offering that tribute. And granted, there were so many of his friends unable to make it here back to Barbados, whether it be Rashawn, a part of the later trio that people know as Trevere, and Raquan as well as the original straight out of O'Year's family, Rajon, being overseas. We have this tribute video, but it also includes that of those who were unable to speak here in person. And we wanted to afford them the opportunity as well for a presentation in this video. So we now turn the attention to the screens for tributes.
Due to certain work circumstances, I was unable to make the funeral today. I just have a few words to say. But Raquan, he was a friend to me, but more like a brother. We did everything together, parties, wherever he'd go, he would see me, wherever I go, he would see him. Raquan was full of joy, always happy, loved to party, always have everyone smiling around him. He was a very, very good person and a great friend. You know, it's very heartbreaking to see such a young person go at that age. I just want to send my condolences to all his family, friends, loved one.
His legacy will always continue.
May God's blessing welcome you with open arms at the heaven gates. This is the life well spent. Rest in peace, my brother. I love you.
Raquan, Rati, flex it to some, you're a brother to me. Time spent is crazy, because they remember the first at Stevens Fair, because they remember the first birthday party down Paul Gear, because they remember the first day I played for Leicester One, because they remember the first day at Leicester One, because they remember the day when you passed for Leicester One, and it was already at Leicester One, and it was like pandemonium. Because we was going to school together and we knew it was going to be a movie. This is a hard one, rap. This is a hard one, bro. Gotta keep it short. Right out the vibes, right out the girls, right out the flair. Rap was my student that became better than me. Because I remember bringing girls up the grind round when I became. Me, you, Baji, and Amar, always a vibe. Cause they remember switching shoes to go. Cause they remember comparing polo. Cause they remember the competition between me and you, who dressed in the hardest. But all in all, gotta keep it sharp before we start tearing up. Rati, love you. We can miss you, brother. I issue heaven, bro. My love, for sure.
Ratty. Long live rap, that's what we all keep saying. That don't even sound normal. Like, I know death can be so unexpected, but I feel like this one caught me totally off guard. Raquan, I go way, way back. We cruise together, we party together, we hold a solo cruise together, we slept side by side many, many times. We was real like brothers, and I love you for everything inside of me. I remember when Rat started to get jealous and play, saying, man, you're real down with me. I offer my brother not know. I would laugh and say, nah, not just a little bit cooler. You still my brother. And he would say, I know he in good hands, man, so he good. Even when we grew older, I wasn't as tight as before. Whenever we talked, it would be like we didn't lose a beat from each other. We didn't always agree on everything. Even when he used to talk, tease me and say, you're a real lover boy. No, I can't believe you settled down. I would say, you next, right? Ain't nothing up here for you but fun. We agreed to disagree and move on. That was us. That was our relationship. If he did something think he shouldn't be doing, I would tell him. And if he would, and he would always say, I know you're looking out for me, but let me live a little bit. That was always Ratty boy. You live life to the fullest with no regrets, and I'm going to miss him. I know you're going to dance up top until we meet again. Watch over us and your young ones. Long live Ratty. I love you, brother. It's cut me deep, but dance, enjoy yourself, live life to the fullest. Word to everyone. I don't live that again.
Good afternoon, everybody. My name is Ayo. And I would like to start off with saying I am honored to be doing this tribute to our truly Rock Rock. I think the world would be a better place with more individuals like Roddy. Kind, loving, and supportive. The way I look at Roddy, he was always ahead of his age. And what I mean by that, he always had a mind of a hustler and a mind of an entrepreneur. The reason why I would say that, I would like to answer all. How many people you know or knew at the age of 15 that wanted a birthday party with friends and family? I can answer that. Majority of us in here. Now, how many people at 15 are thinking of holding their own event with admission fees, DJs, sponsors, and most importantly, looking for income after their segment? I can tell you who. Rock. Death is the most peculiar thing. We're so helpless in the face of it. It's like a window that will simply open on its own accord. The room goes cold and we can't do nothing but shiver. But it opens a little less. Each time. And a little less. And one day we wonder what has become of it. But this one I can't get understand. I probably will never either. I know death is for all of us, but this one just doesn't feel right. But the Lord had other plans, buddy. You're gone. We will never, ever, ever be forgotten. I love you and I miss you dearly. I would like to send my condolences to moms, to Rock children, friends, and family. And I would like everybody in church, everybody who studied in church, the Most who can't make it are watching it online. If you love rap and respect rap, I'll let everybody take the stance for me. Put your hands in the air like this. Now you're pulling the trigger. Long live Rocky. 1, 2, 3. Long live Rocky.
Give your last call.
We now ask the family to come forward for the last call of the viewing before we start the service. So we now ask for the last call for the viewing of Raquan Kemar Tairese Gaskin before the casket is closed.
I raise my hand and my lighter. Jesus, I believe in you. Jesus, I belong to you. You're the reason that I live, the reason that I sing with all that I am.
Temptation.
Let's all stand, please. Let us pray. Almighty God, we give your name honor, we give your name glory, we give your name praise. As we proceed with this funeral service, we ask that your power would be revealed even now, and that everything we do should be done to your highest honor and glory. In Jesus' name, amen. Jesus said, I am the resurrection and I am the life. He who believes in me, though he were dead, yet shall he live. And whoever lives and believes in me shall never die. The steadfast love of the Lord never ceases. His compassion never fails. Every morning they are renewed. Jesus said, let not your hearts be troubled. You believe in God, believe also in me. In my Father's house are many rooms. If it were not so, I would have told you. I go to prepare a place for you. And if I go to prepare a place for you, I will come again and receive you unto myself, that where I am, there you may be also. I be sure that neither death nor life, nor angels, nor principalities, nor powers, nor things present or things to come, or height or depth, nor anything else in all creation will be able to separate us from the love of God in Christ Jesus our Lord. If we live, we live to the Lord. And if we die to the Lord. So then, whether we live or whether we die, we are the Lord. For to this end Christ died and lived again, that he might be the Lord both of the dead and of the living. We brought nothing into this world, and we take nothing out. The Lord gives and the Lord takes away. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Good evening to all of you gathered in this house of worship this afternoon. We want to first of all give God thanks for being here and his presence with us. Dearly beloved, we are gathered here in the presence of God and in your presence to give God thanks for the life, work, and witness of our departed brother, Raquan. We give God thanks that we are able to come and celebrate his life. To you members of the family, close friends, relatives, to all of you, we sincerely offer our deepest condolences, and we trust that God in his infinite mercy and grace will grant unto you the strength and the faith and the courage you need to go forth at a time such as this. I am Reverend Trevor Bino from the Black Rock Church of the Nazarene, and assisting this afternoon is the Reverend Dr. Samuel Elcock from the Ruby Church of the Nazarene. May the Lord bless us all as we continue. Let us pray. Almighty God, God of all grace, mercy, and truth, we humbly bow in your presence this afternoon. We give thanks to you, Lord God, for giving us life. Your word tells us that you give us life and you give it to us in abundance. It is our duty to reach out and embrace your love, your gift, and your life that you've given unto us. Lord, I pray that the Holy Spirit would descend upon this place in a mighty and in a powerful way. Lord God, we come against every plan and every trick of the enemy now. I release the blood of Jesus Christ to prevail over this sanctuary, to cover this place from the outside onto the inside. And may no spirit of Satan would be allowed to interrupt, disrupt, or cause any challenge in this service this evening. We declare the fullness of the blessings of Almighty God in this place, in the name of the Father, the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Reverend Elcock will come to you at this time. God bless you.
Thank you very much, Reverend Bino. Let me say a very good afternoon to all of you, even though for most of us it's not a good afternoon. Nevertheless, we want to thank God for the life of our friend Raquan. I'm sure that there are those who, as they reflect on his life, would have very fond memories of him. I've happened to have pastored the church at Black Rock just about 23 years or so ago, and I've been informed that he would have been a Sunday school boy at the time. Now I am seeing him as a young man. So as we worship God this afternoon, as we celebrate the life of this young man, the beautiful hymn that we have been asked to sing at the opening hymn. And I believe that in times like these, this is a very appropriate hymn. Sometimes our friends fail us, but you know what? What a friend we have in Jesus. All of our sins and griefs to bear. What a privilege to carry everything to God and prayer. So let's sing that song with assurance this evening that God is able. And for the Jamal Slocum, he's going to be leading us in worship.
Come on, let's give God thanks and praise. one, a friend we have in Jesus.
Come on.
All our sins and grief to bear.
Come on.
What a privilege to get.
Everything to God in prayer.
Everything to God in prayer.
Oh, what peace we often forfeit.
Oh, what peace we often.
Oh, what needless pain we bear.
Oh, what needless pain we bear.
All because we do not carry. Come on.
All because we do not carry everything to God.
Have we trials and temptations? Come on, praise the Lord.
Have we trials and temptations?
Is there any trouble? Is there trouble?
There's trouble.
We should never be discouraged. Come on, clap your hands. Let's give God thanks and praise. Let's go. Take it to the Lord. Can we find a friend so faithful?
Oh, can we? Who will all our
Jesus knows our every weakness. Come on.
Jesus knows our every weakness.
Take it to the Lord.
Take it to the Lord and pray.
Are we weak? Come on.
Are we and heavy laden?
Cumbered,
cumbered, cumbered with a load of care.
Oh, precious, precious, precious Savior. Take it to the Lord in prayer. Come on. Take it. Friends despise, forsake thee. You know, come on.
Thy friend despise, forsake thee.
Oh,
take it to the Lord.
Oh,
oh, oh.
Hey.
In his arms he'll take and shield me.
What a friend we have in Jesus. Let's take it in top.
Oh, yeah. What a friend we have in Jesus.
Oh,
all our sins and griefs.
If you love the Lord, it's free to clap your hands and give God thanks and praise. Come on.
Pray.
Lord. Praise the Lord.
Thank you so very much, worship team. You may be seated. And I want to assure you this afternoon that regardless to what you are going through, Pam, I know that it's not going to be easy for you and all the other members of the family, but we certainly do have a friend in Jesus. There's some questions that it would seem to us as there are no answers for. I'm sure so many of you are going to ask yourself why at such a tender age, but God knows best. God knows best. And I can afford to say to you that underneath are the everlasting arms. At this time, the Jamal Slocum, he's going to pay a tribute in song at this time.
Good evening once again. Janelle asks that, his mom asks that this evening we don't do any songs that are too flat or are too boring, that Raquan lived a life that was full and fulfilling. And I thought a million times of what song I could possibly do here for Raquan. And, you know, I just thought about how he would want to be remembered and the bond that he would want us to have at this time, and to depend on each other and to love each other. Sometimes in our lives, we all have pain. We all have sorrow. But if we are wise, we know that there's always tomorrow. Lean on me when you're not strong. I'll be your friend. I'll help you carry on, for it won't be long till I'm gonna need somebody to lean on. You just call on me, brother, when you need a hand. We don't need somebody to lean on. I might just have a problem that you'll understand. We all need somebody. Look to the person beside of you. You can say with me, come on. Lean on me when you're not strong, and I'll be your friend. Hug somebody. I'll help you. Come on, say it with me, come on. I might
I'll help you. Oh, for till I'm gonna need somebody to lead. One more time. Lean on me. Hug somebody. When you're, you don't need to know the person. There's Raquan here. I'll help you carry on, for you won't be long till I'm gonna need somebody to lean on. And that's Raquan's love. Blessings.
Thank you so very much, Jamal. I am sure that in life, every one of us, at some point in time, we do need someone to lean on. And trust me, this is not easy to deal with. I've had the opportunity of officiating at so many funerals, but there's something about the death of a young man or a young woman. And I'm sure that the family do need us to lean on. And by God's grace, He will help them to get through this. Would you stand with me at this time as we read God's word? Psalm 90 is going to be read by Donna Tull. Psalm 90.
Good evening, church. The scripture reading is taken from Psalm 90:90. O Lord, you have always been our home. Before you created the hills or brought the world into being, you were eternally God and will be God forever. You tell man to return to what he was. You change him back to dust. 1,000 years to you are like one day. They are like yesterday already gone. Like a short hour in the night, you carry us away like a flood. We last no longer than a dream. We are like weeds that sprout in the morning, that glow and burst into bloom. They dry up and die in the evening. We are destroyed by your anger. We are terrified by your fury. You place our sins before you, our secret sins, where you can see them. Our life is cut short by your anger. It fades away like a whisper. 70 years is all we have, 80 if we are strong. Yet all they bring us is troubles and sorrow. Life is soon over and we are gone. Who has felt the full power of your anger? Who knows what fear your fury can bring? Teach us how short life is, so that we may become wise. How much longer will your anger last? Have pity, O Lord, on your servants. Fill us each morning with your constant love, so that we may sing and be glad all our life. Give us now as much happiness during all our years of misery. Let us, your servants, see your mighty deeds. Let our descendants see your glorious might. Lord, our God, may your blessings be with us and give us success in all we do. Here ends the Bible reading.
Thank you so very much, Donna, for reading the Word of God for us this evening. Can I ask you to please remain standing as we worship God with this song, Spirit, Lead Me. I'm sure that as we worship God this evening in our hearts, even though overwhelmed, we can still think of the goodness of God. In every situation, we have been told to give God thanks. We don't understand a lot of things, but one thing we do understand is that nobody cares for us like Jesus. Spirit, lead me. Thank you so very much, worship team. I'm going to ask you to be seated at this time to read for us the eulogy. I'm going to ask Wanda Gaskin and Rhonda Robinson to come and read for us the eulogy at this time.
Raquan Kemar Tairese Gaskin, also known as Rat Rat, was called home to work with God as an angel on January 9, 2004. Raquan's untimely death occurred in Powell's Bay, Spring Garden, at his home. Raquan was born on March 4, 2000, to his mother Janelle Gaskin and his dad Ryan Briggs, who passed away when Raquan was only 12 years old. Raquan attended St. Stephen's Primary School, Lester Van High School, and Lenore's Boys School, where he did completed upper fifth and sixth form. Raquan was the CEO of Young Cutters Entertainment Group, which he started at the age of 12, with Straight Outta Gold Cup and Old Years. Raquan loved being a party promoter, and loved fashion so much, he even started his own clothing business. He then migrated to Canada and the USA for a short period, but quickly returned to Barbados to be with his kids. Raquan will be remembered for his vibrant personality and his love for life. He brought so much joy and laughter to those around him with his infectious smile, playful nature, and his amazing personality. He was very mature for his age and could have gravitated to any age group. Raquan, he was a hustler and a devoted father. However, Raquan was also many other things, such as ambitious, supportive, caring, respectful, thoughtful, kind, resilient, humble, and overall a great young man. Raquan touched so many lives and will be remembered forever. Raquan will be deeply missed by his family and his friends. He leaves behind his mother, Janelle, grandmother, grandfather, Leonard and Richard, siblings, Renaco and Armani, uncles, Kemar and Jimar, cousins, great uncles, great aunts, but most importantly, his world, his everything, his two beautiful children. Ricardo Gaskin, age 4, and Relayla Gaskin, age 2, whom he loved dearly. He also leaves behind a host of extended family and friends who were touched by his presence. Although his time with us was cut short, Rat Rat's memories will forever live in our hearts. We will think of him in silence, we will speak his name, we will love him forever, and may his soul sleep in eternal paradise.
Thank you so very much for having read the eulogy for us. And
good afternoon to the congregation. On the behalf of the family, I would like to express our heartfelt thanks to all of you for the outpour of love and support over the past few weeks, which my godson's untimely death has generated. It has been truly extraordinary. It would be remiss of me not to welcome you to this homegoing service and thank you for honoring us with your presence. The following is read in dedication to the late Raquan Kemar Tairese Gaskin. We little knew that morning that God was going to call your name. In life, we loved you dearly. In death, we'll do the same. It broke our hearts to lose you, but you did not go alone, for a part of us went with you that day God called you home. You left us peaceful memories. Your love is still our guide, And though we can no longer see you, you're always by our side. Our family's chain was broken. Now nothing seems the same. But as God calls us one by one, that chain will link again. While we know that unpredictable deaths occur with regularity, they still evoke insufferable hurt and disbelief, especially when someone so very precious to us is called to eternal rest in the prime of their lives. It personalizes and heightens an awareness of both the fragility and preeminence of the magnificent gift of human life. Wistfully, in a split second, not only was a valued life lost, but the lives of our family and those of Raquan's treasured friends have been forever altered. Undoubtedly, nothing could have prepared us for such a devastating moment. Hence, we all wish that we had been given the chance to say goodbye. Nonetheless, there is certainty that he transitioned, knowing the magnitude in which he was loved. Raquan Kemar Tairese Gaskin was born to Janelle Gaskin and the late Ryan Briggs on the fourth day of March in the year 2000. Affectionately known to most as Rat Rat or Flexer, he spent his childhood years at Pyle Bay Spring Gordon with his two siblings, Renaco and Ormani, both of whom he cherished daily. Raquan felt privileged to be the first of his mother's male triad, and from boyhood assumed the dominant role as the family's young patriarch, given that his dad preceded him when he was a mere 12 years old. The visibility of his protective spirit was recognized by all who came into contact with him. He exemplified the meaning of, "I am my brother's keeper." Author Craig D. Loughborough said, and I quote, "The principle of first things first only work if you have the right list in the right order." Indeed, Raquan was a model firstborn whose personality was shaped by a combination of his genetics and by extension, his environment. Notably, Janelle and Janice were stellar role models who showered Raquan with immense love. By the same token, their nurturing spirits enabled his phenomenal inherited traits of being charismatic, dependable, fun-loving, free-spirited, goal-oriented, and last but foremost, spoiled. His privileged status as first child was at times misconstrued and said to generate curried parental favor on his part when the other siblings were added to the equation. Though admittedly, as it related to our little charmer, we all, myself included, from the outset, adopted the can-do-no-wrong stereotype as he had one role, to always remain the baby of the family. Primarily, he was educated at the St. Stephen's Primary School and later transitioned to the Lester Vaughan Secondary School, where he received a mere segment of his secondary education. The final leg of his secondary school journey afforded him the honor of graduating an alumnus from the St. Leonard's Boys at the level of sixth form. Raquan excelled in everything he undertook. He was a good student who, in his formative years, began cultivating an intense appreciation for business management. Further, his strong leadership skills piqued his interest into the world of commerce and entrepreneurship. He wanted to formulate a deeper understanding of the interrelated nature of business issues, theories, and techniques, hence the genesis of Young Cutters Entertainment Group. Commendably, at the age of 12, he proved himself a non-parallel independent events promoter and CEO. Under his keen management and by way of effective brainstorming and promoting, Raquan successfully hosted the memorable events straight out of Gold Cup and All Years. Moreover, this was just the tip of the iceberg for this overzealous youngster. It therefore came as no surprise when he informed his goal to Janelle that she somehow needed to increase his yearly travel periods, as he intended to embark on a new business venture, a clothing franchise. Truth be told, as difficult a task as it may have seemed to some, to Janelle, it was an easy ask. For those of us who in-depthly know Janelle, when trusted into her element of motherhood, we can attest her love is her ultimate sacrifice, and she would give her everything to ensure her children's happiness. Looking back, what was remarkable is how alive Raquan became to the plight and the needs of his two children, Rakairo and Ralela. He was at his happiest when surrounded by them. His love for them was unimaginable. Little did this young dad know, when he briefly moved to Canada to be with his mom and brothers, that he would be torn between his love for family and the void he now exhibited for them. The latter took precedence, and Raquan quickly returned home. Kai's mom, Lou, fondly remembers this awesome dad as one who believed in destiny. Raquan was adamant that their son would make his grand entrance into the world on his birthday. She dovishly disagreed, having her own hopes that he would be born 2 days later on her birthday. Lou's disappointment surely came, and Raquan emerged victorious. All things considered, Lou is thankful to God that her male offspring will carry on the legacy of a dad who introspectively and undoubtedly lived up to his mantra of being half man, half amazing. It is difficult to summarize one's life or their exceptional deeds into a single tribute. As I sat with the family to gather constructive input for my beloved godson's eulogy, the following quotes were shared with me. His mom, Janelle, heartbroken by the indelible loss of her eldest son, states, beginning quote verbatim, "Today is indeed the most difficult day of my life. Losing a child is a devastating occurrence for any mother. There is simply a sense that events are taking place out of sequence. It is simply unnatural. A child buries the parent, not the parent buries the child. Conversely, for parents that have endured this devastating loss, they have a unique comprehension that there is simply no way to prepare for the horror and grief and sorrow that follows. My son has often been described as a gentle soul. He was pure of heart and had great sensitivity for the world around him. He had a way with people that made them feel comfortable, which caused them to gravitate towards him. Raquan exuded kindness and pulled generosity and altruism out from everyone he touched. He was not only my best friend, but a trusted friend to everyone he encompassed. Thank you for 23 of the most amazing years of my life, and apologies for not realizing sooner that we had been living in the presence of an angel. My love for you began far beyond before your birth, and that love will endure for all the days after your death, clear through eternity. Rest with the angels, my prince." Grandmother Janice remembers that special day Raquan came into the world like it was yesterday. She remarks, "Welcoming you into this world was the most wonderful experience and an extremely precious time in my life. You were my special gift. It was as though I had been blessed with an additional son. I was that overprotective grandmother who sought to find balance between helping you to develop into the responsible, independent, fun-loving, appropriate risk-taker, which you indeed were, and keep you emotional and physically safe. Losing you has left me with dashed hopes and shattered dreams for the trajectory of potential greatness that is now absent from our lives. Your death has brought a profound sense of heartbreak, which I can't even begin to explain in this mist of sadness. Guided by my faith, I however have a hope. The hope I have remains in God and in being reunited someday with you in heaven. Rest well, my precious baby boy. Granddad Richard, who resides in the United States and is unable to join us in the physical capacity due to illness, remembers his grandson as a young man filled with unlimited potential. His laugh was infectious and brightened up an entire room. Moreover, it was admirable to see a young man so committed to his duties as a dad. As I share the following, I am covered in tears, saddened to know that such a promising young life has been cut short. Rest well, son, knowing that the future plans you had for your two small children will not be suppressed. You have left behind one of the greatest and most dependable support systems. Granddad will forever love you. Renaco highlights what it's like to be the middle child. My brother and I had two entirely different personalities. I am of the belief that being the middle child afforded me the opportunity to embrace my unique personality of being diplomatic, nurturing, and introspective. My brother and I were indeed opposites. I was viewed as the introvert while he was the extrovert. Despite the trivial discord between us at times, it has never outweighed our close fraternal ties. We had an unconditional love for each other. As I navigate this delicate tapestry of grief, I humbly celebrate the joy and bliss which you have brought to my life. Forever in my heart, big brother. Candidly put, Armani credits his big brother for being a great mentor and guide. We shared many similar likes. He loved to dance, and so do I. He taught me to match my outfits with the most fashionable sneakers. I miss him a lot and wish he was still here. Not having him visit my mom and I when we return to Canada will be quite strange. It scares me to know that I will never see him again. I love you forever, my number one big brother. Understandably, most may wonder, how does age factor into the dynamics of the siblings? Having lost her biological twin brother, Raquan graciously and exuberantly undertook the role, not as her godbrother. He made it abundantly clear to us that age was indeed his little sister. They loved each other wholeheartedly. Age appends the following. I am confident in knowing that every girl wishes that they were privileged enough to have had an amazing big brother such as Raquan. He was definitely a dominant force in my life. The pain of losing him is indeed palpable, making it extensively hard to say goodbye. Undoubtedly, he was to me a teacher of all things, underpinned by the essential skills of self-awareness, self-discipline, emotional intelligence, positive thinking, and goal setting. Raquan was simply the perfect big brother, and for this, my love and gratitude runs endless. Sleep in peace, my sweet big brother. Not one day will go by where memories shared with you will fade or become obsolete. I will forever love you. Grief is undoubtedly not linear. Sadly, no one makes it through life without experiencing grief. It is the heart-wrenching flip side that which makes life worth living, love. The passage of time will never really heal the memory of such a great loss, a life gone too soon, but we carry on guided by our faith because Raquan would have wanted us to, as we honor the life of a fellow son, brother, father, cousin, and trusted friend, let us remember those we love don't go away. They walk beside us every day, unseen, unheard, yet always near, still loved, still missed, and always dear. Rest in perfect peace and rise in glory, my sweet godson. You will forever be in our hearts, a cherished memory, a beautiful dream, and a love that knows no end. God, mommy loves you.
Thank you so very much, Wanda and Rhonda, for having shared with us eulogy, which gives to us an idea as to the life of our loved one and friend. At this time, we are going to be having a special solo by Shade Marshall.
Gonna do this one to pay a special tribute to our angel, Raquan. Always used to like to play games.
I sit and wait. Does an angel contemplate my faith? Ooh, I've been told that salvation lets the wings unfold. So when I'm lying in my bed, thoughts running through my head, and I feel the love is dead, I'm loving angels and say, yeah. Ooh, I'm loving angels and say, through it all, she offers me protection, a lot of love and affection, whether I'm right or wrong, and down the waterfall. Wherever it may take me, I know that life won't break me. When I come to call, he won't forsake me. I'm loving angels instead. When I'm feeling weak and my pain walks down a one-way street, I look above and I know I'll always be blessed with so much love. And as the feeling grows, he breathes flesh through my bones. And when love is dead, I know you know the words, sing with me. I'm loving angels instead. And through it all, he offers me protection, a lot of love and affection, whether I'm right or wrong. And down the waterfall, wherever it may take me, I know that life won't break me. When I come to call, He won't forsake me. I'm loving angels instead. Oh, ah, loving them, I'm loving them. Ah, loving them, I'm loving them, I'm loving them. Yes, I am. Oh, ooh, ooh, ooh. Oh, and through it all, He offers me protection, a lot of love and affection, whether I'm right or wrong. And down the waterfall, wherever it may take me, I know that life won't break me. When I come to call, He won't forsake me. I'm loving angels instead.
Thank you.
Ministry interest today in song. At this time, we're going to be having what is considered to be the donation song, and it speaks to the goodness of God. I'm sure that every one of us, regardless who we are, as we reflect on our own lives, we can truly say that God is a good God. Those persons who like to worship standing, you can stand, and those of you who would prefer to be seated, you're also free to do that as we sing that song, Goodness of God.
God is good. God is good.
All the time.
And all the time.
You, Lord, for Your mercy never fails me. All my days I've been held in Your hand. From the moment that I wake up until I lay my head, I will sing of the goodness of God. All my life You have been faithful.
If you know it, sing with me. Come on, Lord, praise God.
All my life You have been so, so good. With every breath that I am able,
let's do the first verse again.
I will sing of the goodness.
Let's take the first verse again.
I love You, Lord. Oh, Your mercy never fails me. All my days I've been held in Your hand. From the moment that I wake up until I lay my head, I will sing of the goodness of God.
All my life You have been faithful.
And all my life You have been so, so good. With every breath that I am able, I will sing of the goodness.
I love You. your voice.
I love your voice. You have led me through the fire. In darkest times, you are close like no other.
I've known you as a father.
I've known you as a friend. I have lived in the goodness of God.
All my life you have been faithful. Come on.
And all my life you have been faithful.
Father Lord, all my life.
And all my life you have been so,
so. Let's do I love your voice.
I love your voice.
You have led me through the fire. In darkest nights, you are close
like no other.
I've known you as a father.
I know you as a father.
Oh, I know you as a friend. Oh, and I have lived
in the good.
Your good.
Oh, your goodness is running after, it's running after me.
Say,
your goodness is running after, it's running after
when
me.
When my life laid down,
when my life laid down, I surrender now. I give you everything.
Oh, 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 oh.
Your goodness is running after, it's running after
your
me.
Goodness, your goodness.
Your goodness is running after, it's running after me.
Everybody say,
your goodness is running after, it's running after me.
With my life laid down, I surrender. Let's do your goodness again. Won't you help me sing, Lord?
All my life you have been so, so good.
Oh.
Every breath that I have made,
no, no, no,
I will sing of the goodness of God.
All my life,
and all my life.
I want you to lift your voice and give God praise.
And all my life you have been so, so good. Every breath that I have made,
oh,
I will sing of the goodness of God.
Your goodness, your goodness.
Your goodness is running after, it's running after. I surrender now.
I give you everything.
Everything. Your goodness is running after. It's running after.
Your goodness, your goodness.
Your goodness is running after.
It's running after me.
Your goodness is running after.
It's running after me.
When my life lay down, I surrender.
One more time, I want to hear the church sing all my life. And all my. If you love the Lord, sing all my life. No matter what you're going through,
the goodness. All my life you have been faithful. Sing it, come on. And all my life you have been faithful. If you know the Lord is good, sing with me, come on.
All my life you have been faithful.
No matter what you're going through, God is good. With every breath that I am able, oh, I will sing of the goodness of God. I will sing of the goodness of God the Lord. And I will sing of the goodness of God. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord! Praise God.
Let the redeemed of the Lord say so, whom he has redeemed from the hand of the enemy. We are really under pressure for time. We are well in advance of the time, but it seems like it's necessary to allow you to hear just for a few moments the word of God. I know that we are pushed for time, so I'm going to ask the Reverend Trevor Bino to come and briefly share with you, and then we are going to have to get to the cemetery. So the Reverend Trevor Bino is going to come at this time and share with us. I'm sorry that we would have had to have left out the second scripture, but we cannot do any better at this time.
Praise the Lord. I would invite you to, if you have your Bibles, or reflect with me from the book of James, chapter 4, verses 13 and 14. James chapter 4, verses 13 and 14. And it reads, "Go to now, ye that say, for today or tomorrow, we will go into such a city and continue there a year and buy and sell and get gain. Whereas ye know not what shall be on the morrow. For what is your life? For what is your life? It is even a vapor that appears for a little while and then vanisheth away." May the Lord bless his words to our hearts. This evening, I want to share quickly with you, asking the question, what is your life? Or what is our lives? What are our lives, rather? We take life in this age for granted. Sometimes we press our chest and we say, this is my life. I can do what I want or what I feel like doing with it. Forgetting that the Bible tells us that between us, death and life, there's just one step that separates us from life to death, that divides us. And life granted unto us by Almighty God, no doubt, is a precious and an important and a valuable gift given to mankind by God. However, it is one that we ought to cherish. It is one we ought to embrace. Is one we ought to be thankful for, because we can do nothing in our own strength to make life better than what it is. We depend upon the mercies of God. And so this evening, we stand in this sanctuary
and we stand with heavy hearts, broken hearts, teary eyes, and so on, because a loved one from among us has been called away at a very tender and a very early age. In life, we begin to set our priorities, set our goals. We look forward to achieving those things that we hope for, we dream for, we long for. And I'm sure that all of us in here this evening, or most of us, will no doubt during the course of life as we begin to grow, that we will begin to think of the things that we want to achieve and accomplish because we are living. And sometimes we do not know how far that life, that lifespan on this side of heaven will take us. I am sure this evening that Raquan no doubt would have been having dreams and desires for his little children to see them grow, to see them develop and become what he would want them to be. Because in life, you make sure you try to put things in place. However, we don't know, but God have called him. We do not. This life is nothing that we can boast about. We've just got to take it and give God thanks every morning that we wake up and see the dawn of a new day. Every morning we wake up and recognize that breath is still breathing in our bodies. We ought to give thanks to all of us here this evening, and especially our young people. I don't know how many of you have been observing, but across the landscape of this country, we have lost a number of young men and young women have gone on. Some lives been taken suddenly without any notice to family or friends or anyone else. Their lives have been taken. However, it was. And it gives us an opportunity then to reflect and to look back at our lives and see where we are, for regardless to what circumstances there may be, we have an appointment with God. We have a day in which the Lord is going to judge us. Therefore, I challenge everyone who have not yet made a commitment or a surrender to the Lord Jesus Christ, make your commitment to him, because no one knows when our day on earth will come to an end. No one knows. Raquan got up that morning, I believe, and I believe full of excitement and looking forward to life. But death has stepped in, because death is that enemy that comes and rob us out of life. I pray that God Almighty would grant unto him eternal rest. I trust and pray that during the course of that time, he would have been able to call upon and experience the mercy of God. May God grant him eternal rest. May you family members, Pam and all others, may you be comforted to know that God is still there on the throne. God is still wrapped in his arms around you to bring you through this difficult time, and he will certainly do it. Just keep your trust, keep your fear, and don't let go on God, because he is good and he is merciful. Shall we stand? Family members, for because of time, I cannot call you as we would want to, but I'm going to pray a prayer on your behalf. Father, in the name of Jesus, We give you thanks for this family, Lord God, as they stand before your throne, broken and hurting at the loss of our loved ones. May they find, O God, comfort in you. May they find strength in you. May they draw from your resources. As the time will go on, they will need your comforting arms. Comfort them, Lord God, with the comfort you've given to us, that they will know at every turn, every eye opening, every breath that they breathe, they will know that the Lord of hosts is with them and that the God of Jacob is their refuge. God bless you all as we prepare for the cemetery. I want to thank the ministers and workers here at New Dimensions Ministry for allowing us the uses of your sanctuary and allowing us to be able to be here, and all the workers, we thank you for your hospitality and your service. We also recognize the presence of our parliamentary representative, the Honorable Neil Rowe. God bless you for being here. And I think I'm seeing Mr. Ryan Walters, if I'm right. Yes, God bless you all for your kind support. God bless.
Let me apologize to Sheena. Of course, I'm sure she would understand because of time. We've had to cut something, so my apologies to you, Sheena.
As we make our exit,
sing my praise to you as a pleasing sacrifice. Lord, I offer you my life. Lord, I offer you my
Good evening to all again. We're about to commence this last segment of this homegoing service. I want to thank you first of all for your cooperation thus far, and I trust and pray in God that as we continue, it will remain in this same vein. Let us pray. Almighty God, we thank you again this evening for the opportunity that we can come and lay our brother remains to the ground. We are grateful, Lord God, that we have his body with us and that his life have not been taken somewhere where it cannot be found. That would have brought more grief and pain to his family. So we give you thanks for your word said in everything, even in the midst of life and death comes, you be ought to give thanks. So we bless your name and pray, mighty God, that we continue this service, your presence will continue to fill this place. Everyone the Father gives to me will come to me. I will never turn away anyone who believes in me. He who raised Jesus Christ from the dead will also give new life to our mortal bodies through his indwelling spirit. My heart, therefore, is glad, and my spirit rejoices. My body also shall rest in hope. You, God, will show me the path of life. In your presence, there is fullness of joy, and at your right hand are pleasures forevermore. I heard a voice from heaven saying, write this. Happy are the dead who die in the faith of Christ. Henceforth, says the Spirit, they may rest from their labors, for they take with them the record of their deeds. Man, born of a woman, has but a short time to live. Like a flower, he blossoms and then withers. Like a shadow, he flees and never stays. In the midst of life, we are in death. To whom can we turn for help? But to you, Lord, who are justly angered by our sins. Lord God, holy and mighty, holy and immortal, holy and most merciful Savior, deliver us from the bitter pains of eternal death. You know the secrets of our heart. In your mercy, hear our prayer. Forgive our sins. And at our last hour, let us not fall away from you. Ensure a certain hope of the resurrection to eternal life through our Lord Jesus Christ. We commend to Almighty God our brother, Raquan Kemar Gaskin, Tairese Gaskin, and we commit his body to the ground, earth to earth, ashes to ashes, dust to dust. And we beseech you, in your infinite mercies, to give us grace to live in your dear love and to die in your favor, that when your well-beloved Son shall come again in judgment, both this our brother and ourselves may be found acceptable in your sight. Grant this for the sake of your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Ghost. Amen.
You can say anything you want to say in between.
Of the goodness Because I know. Let's say it together. There is power in the name of Jesus. There is power in the name of Jesus. Say, there is power in the name of Jesus. Come on. To break every chain, break every chain. Break every chain, yeah. To break every chain, break every chain, break every chain. Let's say it together, there is power. There is power in the name of Jesus. You got it. So there is power in the name of Jesus. There is power in the name of Jesus, yeah. To break every chain, break every chain. Declare and say, to break every chain, break every. Now somebody lift your hands in the air right here. See, there's an army. We won't keep silent, say, there's an army. Say, there's an army. There's an army rising up. Now shut it up, say, to break every chain. To break every chain. Break every chain. Break every chain. Say, to break up.
Break every chain.
Mwah. I love you. Okay, bye.
When I first laid eyes on you and I heard your heartbeat too, oh, I never knew I could witness an angel so beautiful. From the very moment you arrived, I felt something new inside. I developed a love that was so unconditional. And I
'Cause you deserve it. Teach you how to treat a woman. Let you know you're gonna be something great. I want for you to shine so bright. Oh, you can do anything through Christ. I see that there is a star inside you. I'm so glad you're in my life. I promise to give you everything that I have. There's not a dream in this world you can't accomplish or grasp. I will cross any ocean before I let you land. Just hold on to mama's hand and never let it go. Oh, 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 just hold on to mama's hand and never let it go. Oh, 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 just hold on to mama's hand and never let it go.
Let us pray. Almighty God, with whom still live the spirit of those who die in the Lord, and with whom the souls of the faithful are in joy and felicity, we give you heartfelt thanks for the good example of all your servants who, having finished their course in faith, now find rest and refreshment. May we, with all who have died in the true faith of your holy name, have perfect fulfillment and bliss in your eternal and everlasting glory, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Merciful God, Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, who is the resurrection of life, raise us, we humbly pray, from the death of the sin and life of righteousness, that when we depart this life, we may rest in him, and at the resurrection receive that blessing which your well-beloved Son shall then pronounce. Come, you blessed of my Father, receive the kingdom prepared for you from the beginning of this world. Grant this, O merciful Father, through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Grant, O Lord, to all who are bereaved the spirit of faith and the courage, that they may have strength to meet the days to come with steadfastness and patience, not sorrowing as those without hope, but in thankful remembrance of your great goodness and in the joyful expectation of eternal life with those they love. And this we ask in the name of our Lord and the Savior, Jesus Christ. Amen.
We want to thank the Lord for, again, being with us in the last moments that we are spending around the mortal remains of our brother. We want to thank God for all of you who would have come and shared your sympathies and your flowers and everything else as you give to this family the great support. Your presence here this evening tells me that you love and you appreciate this family very, very much. So on their behalf, I would want to say thank you for coming and gracing this place with your presence. I would also want to say thank you for the behavior and the way you handle yourself this evening. I appreciate your behavior very, very much. The Lord bless you, and may he keep you. And now, as we come to the close of this session, in the last moments that we will spend around the remains of our brother, Raquan, Kemar, Tairese, Gaskin, this session now brings to a close the earthly journey of our dear brother. May he rest in peace. May he rise in glory. May he be able to be around the throne of grace when the trumpet shall sound and the dead in Christ shall rise. God bless all of you. Thanks for your appreciation. And when you're leaving, do have a safe journey home. Prepare now for the releasing of the pigeons. God bless.
Are brighter, even though you're not here with me. Yeah. So sad to say goodbye, but I know way up high in the sky, yeah, God needed an angel to do his work. Fight to keep your memory burning like this flame, yeah.
Though I could pride myself in battles won, for I've been blessed beyond measure, for by his strength alone I overcome. Oh, I could stop and count successes like diamonds in my hand, but his trophies could not equal to the grace by which I stand. In Christ alone I place my trust and find my glory in the shadow of the cross. In every victory, let it be said of me, my source of strength, my source of hope is Christ alone.
If you give a little more than you take, and if you try to fix more than you break, if you're the kind who takes the time to help a stranger in the rain, there's a place for people like you. If you stand,
so we going over the bush bar. I wanna know that rock rock. We wanting a birthday cruise for rock rock. So we can hold a promotion by the bush bar tonight, cause we can still celebrate. Like, yeah, this never happened before. So everybody, a live promotion going down tonight, 7 o'clock. But if you don't want to go home, we got food down by the bush bar and drinks on sale. So I ain't going home, so I know I going straight like me. Cause it look nice. Huh? Promotion at 7. Be a gent time. 7 o'clock. 7:30 the latest. Cruise time. 5 o'clock. That is what's going on. So everybody, we would like the support tonight. Cause you don't know. If Rat Rat was here, he would like that everybody come up. And we still got t-shirts and badges. So a badge is $5. And a t-shirt is how much? 50. So that right in the car. You never go left the cemetery. We go right here. So big up to everybody that come out today for my brother Rat Rat. And I just want to say this is a great, great turnout for my brother. And big up to Janelle. Big up to all the people outside today that support Janelle, Pam, Armani, Ranako, the whole family tree is too much to call. But big up on yourself. When I really met today, look real sweet. And when I blue, and who ain't make it in blue and come and show respect. We love when I celebrate tonight. Get drunk like me, because right now I'm on 18 rule boys. So get drunk like me tonight. Yeah, big up. Bye bye. Love when I.
Like a comet blazing across the evening sky, gone too soon. Like a rainbow fading in the twinkling of an eye, gone too soon. Spot. shine splendidly bright. Here one day, gone one night. Like the loss of sunlight on a cloudy afternoon. Upon a sandy beach, gone too soon. Like a perfect flower that is just beyond your reach, gone too soon. A sunset dying with the rising of the moon.
I live. With a grateful heart, with a song of praise, with an outstretched arm, I will bless your name and thank you, Lord. I just wanna thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. I just wanna thank you, Lord. Oh, thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. I just wanna thank you, Lord. Wanna thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Lord, we thank you. Oh, we thank you, Lord.